I rode into a frightened town. I could feel it in the air. On the faces of the people was the blankness of despair. I'd ridden hard to reach this town. I thought that it might be a place where I could settle down, where no one knew of me. I rode by the nervous town folk who were standing in the sun. I smiled at them, but in return they kept staring at my gun. The old familiar sickness started churning up inside. Now they'd ask if it was true that 13 men had died. First would come the curious, and then the would-be brave, to try for a reputation or a senseless early grave. But no, these folks, they welcomed me like I was their old friend. Could be that here was peace at last, that I'd reach my journey's end. But hope died quickly as they spoke. I chilled in the sweltering sun. To them I wasn't friend or foe, just a fast and deadly gun. They wanted me to kill again, to save the town, they said. I told them that I'd fight no more. Too many men were dead. But even as I turned away, there came riding down the street as bad a pair of gunmen as a man would ever meet. I said, "Dear Lord, please help this town and those who soon will die." But this was none of my concern. I watched them ride on by. I got a room and locked the door, and I fell asleep at last, wondering if there was a lawman, hoping his gun was fast. Then I came to my feet with gun in hand to the sound of a six-gun's roar. There were frantic footsteps in the hall and a pounding at my door. "If there's any mercy in your heart, please help us now," they cried. "The sheriff's hurt, two men are down, and a little child has died." Just one last time I'd have to fight, then I'd be one of them. I'd found a home at last. I'd be like other men. My gun felt strange, my heart was light as I faced them in the street. I even smiled as they went down and lay dying at my feet. The blood was running from my wounds as I was sinking to the ground. But my newfound friends would care for me. You see, I'd found my town. Before my wounds had time to heal, they all had lost their fear. I asked about my newfound friends. Not a one of them came near. Then a spokesman came to me. He said, "Speaking for the town, we're grateful for the help you gave. We just don't want your kind around." Then, with a deeper wound inside than a bullet ever made, I rode away with a darker past. I even tried to pray, for fate was moving me again as a blood-red sun went down, with a few more scars, down an endless road to another frightened town.